So you did a cool woodworking design in CAD, and now you need to figure out how many boards and sheet goods you need to go buy in order to actually make it. My name is Corbin Dunn, and I'm going to talk about my process for how I do this in Autodesk Fusion. Spoiler alert, I use a plugin, MapBoards Pro, I'll link to it below. And getting an estimate is a little bit different than what I actually do for when I go and cut things out, because each board is just a little bit different than every other board, and sometimes you have to work around defects. And everything I'm going to talk about is applicable for just general woodworking, but a lot of it will also apply to CNC woodworking, and I'll talk about some of the specifics on what I do differently for the CNC as I come across them. So the first thing you have to do is download and install the MapBoards Pro plugin for Autodesk Fusion. And yes, this plugin does cost $25, but it is well worth it because the alternative is to maybe use the built-in feature in Fusion, where they have nesting. However, that's hidden behind the manufacturing extension, which costs $1,500 a year, and I'd rather pay $25 once to an individual developer than $1,500 to Fusion and Autodesk. And let's start with these curved shop windowsills. I'll have the CAD file available to download so you can see exactly what I ended up doing. So here's the first example. These are my shop windowsills, and I wanna go ahead and generate a cut list, figure out how many boards I'm going to need. And this is gonna be how I generally do it. So first, I'm gonna go ahead and create and run MapBoards Pro, the plugin. And it's gonna go ahead and figure out what we're gonna be actually mapping out onto some boards, or another word for it is nesting, or figuring out a cut list. Let's take a look at some of the options first and what I like to set. I like to set the map output to be component bodies, and this way I can tweak things afterwards, and that's particularly useful for a CNC layout. And I use inches because it's what I'm stuck in. Component spacing is how far it's gonna actually space each component on the board. And if you're gonna cut out on the CNC, you probably want this to be at least as wide as your bit, plus a little bit of extra spacing, or even wider because you may actually want to leave some tabs in between. Trim on edge board is also the same thing. If you're gonna be holding down the sides of your board with something that you don't wanna hit on the CNC, or just have some extra waste if you're just doing traditional cutout, that's what you would put for here. And other things that I like to do, use appearance. So use appearance, that will vary how the software works. By default, the software is going to categorize things by material, which is a little bit different than the appearance and what you see. And I'll talk about more of that in a little bit. So what it did is it figured out in this project, I have two different thicknesses of boards. Now I haven't set materials for them, so it's showing up as steel, and I'm just gonna ignore that because it doesn't matter to me. For more complex projects, I will actually go and set the actual material. And what I'm gonna do here is I wanna just get an estimate. And so let's say that when I go to the lumber store, I know I can find boards at least 6 inches wide, which is probably wide enough for this particular project. So for just an estimate, I'm gonna say, okay, my board widths are 6 inches. My length, let's say, is 10 feet because that's pretty typical. And so I'm gonna go ahead and fill that in for my estimates here. 6 inches wide, 120 inches long. And I'm gonna clear my selection and I'm gonna go and check each of the components I want to map out. Or you could just check include entire model if you're gonna do that. And it gives you a list down here of what's gonna be mapping. And the first time I run it, I just run it on everything and hit okay. Okay, so after the program ran, I like to go ahead and hide my components that I'm actually are part of my design. And usually I'll put them in one group or one master component to hide them really easily. And so what this does, it now gives me a quick estimate of how many boards I'm gonna need. And it looks like I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 boards for this particular project. So awesome, go to the lumber store and buy them. Okay, so you went to the wood store and you now know exactly how many boards you have and how wide they are and what defects you can avoid in them. So now you can go back to MapBoards Pro, you can go ahead and run it again. And you may have to reselect all the components that you want to generate. They do have to be visible. By default, the program will only work on things that are actually visible. So I'm gonna go ahead and reselect what I want to map out here for this first example. And so let's say that I know my boards are now actually 12 inches wide. You can actually go ahead and add stock for each individual board here. And I will sometimes do this, but not very often. You hit OK, and what it's going to do is it's going to remap things out on that wider stock. Now, what it did is it went and deleted the old map, which is good or bad depending on how you look at it. And I'll talk a little bit more about that in just a minute. So here you have your actual map. I'm gonna go ahead and hide the things that I don't wanna look at and just look at the map. Now, at this point, I may want to tweak exactly how things are laid out to avoid actual defects I see in the boards at a particular location, or to just space things a little bit differently if I have this space. And for this particular example, I'm going to want to cut it out in the CNC, and I do have the space. And there are a couple ways to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and expand the map that generated. And this program does a couple things that are wonderful, and what it does is it actually generates some joints for each of these they can tweak. So for here, let's say I want this top piece to actually be flipped. I want them to be top to bottom just because I don't like this orientation. So you can go ahead and you can right click on the joint. You can edit joint. And if I want to be 180, I can go ahead and just replace things. And then hit OK. And I can do that for all the other ones. Right click, edit joint, 180. And let's say I want more spacing between it, so I can kind of space things a little bit differently. Now, I will also sometimes just go ahead and manually select the components and move them. And I think it's okay to do that if you make some assumptions with how the software is working. First of all, I need to be on the top view. If I go ahead and move these components when I'm not directly in the top view, you're gonna probably move them on the Z-axis a little bit, which is gonna mess up some of the things for cutting it out in the CNC. So I make sure I'm on the top. And if you're on the top, you can go ahead and tweak the layout of where things are. So I could put these boards just a little bit off, could move these guys a little bit closer together. And you could use this with the joints if you want, or you can just manually drag things around. And after I do that, I like to do a capture position, and that way the position is saved in Fusion, so when you reopen it up, it will appear again. Of course, one of the things that either I like or I don't like is if you were to run the program again at this point, the MapBoards Pro plugin, it would delete your map. And if you're using the CNC like I am, you probably have all your toolpaths cut out for one particular board, and you want to run it again on another board. And I do that all the time. So I don't want to actually delete the map. And I figured out a workaround on how to do this, which isn't really officially supported in the software. But I go ahead and rename things, and I rename two things. I rename the map, so let's say I make this to be the map of the top. And then I go ahead and I right-click on the actual timeline for that map generation, and I rename it. By default, the name is MapBoards. If you rename it to something else, MapBoards Pro will not realize that connection is there anymore, and it won't delete that map, and it'll just leave it. And I find this to be really powerful to leave my existing map there for one particular thing, and to go ahead and create another map for another board. Because a lot of times when I'm doing woodworking, I reiterate on things and have to just do things again and again from the model. And this is great for having a history of what I did with the CNC. So if I go over to the manufacturing tab on this particular model, I can see exactly what I did because the board and the mapping wasn't deleted when I want to go and add another one for another board. Now, let's see how I can go and set up toolpaths for CNC by utilizing some of the things that MapBoard Pro did for us. So as an example, I'm going to just set up some new toolpaths with a new setup for this particular project. So if I go setup, new setup, and let's take a look at what MapBoard Pro gives us that makes things a little bit easier. So first of all, I'm going to select my model. And if I go to my mapping, and let's say I want to cut out the top and bottom pieces of a board, I'll go ahead and select those inside the model. And next, the most important part is that you can set up your stock from what MapBoard Pro generated. So I go and set the mode to be from solid. I can expand the mapping, go to the board that I'm working on and want to cut out, and there's a body for the particular board. And I can go ahead and select it, which is awesome. Now, the orientation may not be set up correctly. I never want to use the center of the board for my actual origin for my CNC work. I like it to be the bottom left of the board. So I set the orientation to be Z-axis and X-axis, and then I can go ahead and select a Z-axis, like the vertical part of my board or my workpiece, and then the X-axis can be the X-axis of the sketch here. And then I can set the origin to be the lower left. Once I do that, I notice that the X is flipped from my direction on what I actually want it to be. So I flip it, and X is going to the right, Y is going away, Z is up, bottom left is my corner. I can hit OK. And some of the things that I will do is I will go ahead in the design and tweak the actual board size for that particular mapping. So if I expand that map and I can go and find that board has a sketch for the actual board, and I can right click on that sketch and edit it to be the actual size of what things may or may not be, because sometimes I will change the board sizes. It's also possible to just go and show that sketch and drag it in real time. So if the board was actually a little bit bigger, I could drag it and be a little bit larger here. And now if I go back to the manufacturing tab, that board is a little bit larger. My origin would be this other location here. Or sorry, it would still be back here. Depends on which side you grab, of course. So that's how I kind of use the models and the bodies that generated to set up my stock inside of Fusion for doing my manufacturing, my toolpaths for CNC work. Now, let me talk a little bit about how I would do this for plywood, because it's just a little bit different. And this is my miter station project. You can download this file and you can actually see the maps that I generated and how I use them. Now, in this project, I'm gonna go ahead and wanna run MapBoards Pro, just as they did before. And this project is heavily plywood based. There's really no regular lumber that I'd be using. And just like before, I'm gonna go ahead and select my two cabinets as the thing I want to run on. And for plywood, 48 by 96, 4x8 is the width and length that I'm gonna put in. And this is gonna use three different sizes of plywood for this particular project. And then I just go ahead and okay, and it's gonna go ahead and map everything out or nest it. So here's the layout of what it just generated for all the plywood sheets. And if I feel like it's kind of wasting some of the layout, such as maybe these boards here could be on the same ones here if there's enough space, I might go ahead and tweak the parameters for the spacing between boards until everything is on one sheet. Now, if you go and download the file that I made for my miter station, you'll see that I did two maps, one for the main 3/4-inch plywood of the carcass, and another one separate for just the drawer pieces. Now, when I cut out the drawers on the flat piece of plywood, I do not want to cut out the joinery because I want to just cut out a rectangle and then mount those up vertically on my work table to cut out the dovetails. So let me show you a trick that I do to work around this. So if I zoom in on a particular board that I want to cut out on the CNC, now I don't want to go and cut all the pins, the profile, I just want to do a rectangle for my board pieces. And one of the things I noticed when you do a mapping in MapBoards Pro, it basically creates an outline of each of the pieces it's laying out, and I can utilize these outlines, these individual sketches here, to actually select as my CNC paths that cuts out. So if I want to just cut out a rectangle around this board and not have it cut the dovetails, I can easily do that. And so that's actually what I did for my manufacturer tab over here for the miter station. If we go and look at all my drawers, we can see that I just selected the outlines for for the actual cutting out and didn't cut out the pins. The other thing to talk about is probably materials and the actual appearance and how those can come into play with this program. And I'm going to use a more complex example. I'm going to use the entry table that I made in my last video. Again, this is a free download, and you can download it and see my actual layouts and mappings and what I did for making it. So this is my table, and like I said before, the way I would actually approach figuring things out is I would just do a general map for everything. So I go create MapBoards Pro, and it's going to chug through everything because there's a lot of stuff here. I like to go and manually select my top level component that I want to map, and that has 56 things in it. You can go and select your boards, and the first time I'd run it is I would just get a rough estimate, make sure I have long lengths for everything and some pretty wide widths, and I hit OK, and I would get a rough estimate. And I already did that for this particular project, and I called it my original map, and I wanted to save it. And this is what I actually did for that project to figure out roughly how many boards I would need for it. Now, this particular project mixes several types of wood. There is no plywood, but it has solid cherry, and it has maple, and it has walnut. And so I wanted to set a physical material to differentiate those. So inside of Fusion, if you type S for searching for something, you can type material, and you can do physical material. And you can just go ahead and find materials that represent what you're making and using. So in this one, I was using maple, cherry, and I guess I didn't do one for walnut, but really I just need those two to differentiate. And you can just drag and drop them on your top level component to apply it to all of the children in addition to that top level one. Or you can drag and drop it on individual bodies. And then once you do that, if you go and right click on a particular piece, you can look at the properties and you can see it has a physical material set to cherry. But also notice that the appearance is actually different. So in this particular project, I typed A for appearance, and I went and dragged a particular appearance on all these pieces for things that I wanted to look a certain way. So the appearance is separate from the material. And that kind of makes sense because you might be using cherry for everything, but you might have like a satin finish on one, you might have a stain on another piece that makes it look different. So you could actually have it look different than what the physical material actually be. And so inside of MapBoards Pro, there's an option where you can set to either use the appearance or use the actual material. And I kind of go back and forth between using those depending on how I set the model up. And I encourage you guys to download my CAD file for this particular project. If you look through it, you'll see I did a lot of individual maps because as I was progressing through the project and I wanted to cut out a particular piece, I would go and find the perfect board for it and then lay things out exactly where I wanted them on that board and then cut them on the CNC. All right, so that's just a general overview on how I use MapBoards Pro. It has a lot of other features. It can generate some cut lists automatically and some reports as HTML files. And I have used those features, but I don't use them all that much anymore. I encourage you to just play around with the program, check out more of the options, and figure out things that might suit your particular needs. As usual, if you have any comments or questions, feel free to ask me down below. I'm happy to help you figure out things.